What's going on, guys, and welcome to another Reputized video. Mortal Engines was directed by Christian Rivers and stars Hera Hilmar, Robert Sheehan, and Hugo Weaving. And it follows two people who meet in London who tries to stop a conspiracy in a post-apocalyptic world from the head of a guild of historian, Thaddeus Valentine. Alright, this movie... Going right into the positives, y'all. As usual, the cinematography and lighting by Simon Raby was done well. It was lit up just perfectly. I know in all my videos I compliment the cinematography, but it is true. Like, most of the movies that comes out, the cinematography... There's, like, very little movies I know of where the cinematography and lighting isn't all that good. But the cinematography and lighting, as I said, was pretty good. It was lit up really well. I can tell when the Blu-ray comes out, it's going to be, like, crystal clear. And it's going to be amazing and everything. The editing by Juno Woodford Robinson was done pretty well. It wasn't choppy, although there was one shot in the first act that was, like, a quick... pass, and it looked a little choppy. It was like real fast, and okay, I didn't feel that was necessary. But other than that, like the rest of the movie, that was only in the first act, but the rest of the movie, it was done really well. Just that one shot, I didn't really feel it was necessary. It didn't really add to it. That's just me. The characters was written really well. The main girl, Hester Shaw, played by Hera, was written really well. At first I didn't really get the build-up. The build-up was a little slow. It kind of sucked. But as you got into her backstory and you find out why she's doing what she's doing, you really feel for this character. She has a personal vendetta against the main antagonist, and I don't blame her. I really don't blame her. Tom Natsworthy, who was played by Robert, did a pretty well job. I feel like through most of the first act of the movie, he was just along for the ride. He just got caught up in all this stuff, and he kind of walked into it. His character kind of accidentally fell into all of this. But as the movie went on, he started becoming more helpful and useful. His character became definitely trustworthy and noteworthy. Thaddeus Valentine, the main antagonist for this film, played by Hugo Weaving. I loved him in The Matrix. I liked him in V for Vendetta. He was okay in Captain America the First Avenger, but The Matrix is what I know him the best. He played Agent Smith in those, and he also plays a really tough bad guy in this film. The antagonist for this film was pretty strong, I do admit. Alright, getting into the negatives, guys, and there's a little more than the positives. There was a character called Shrieker. He was like this undead creature, and he was also the guardian of Hester's character. I felt like his character was a little bit of a waste. When he first showed up, I wasn't really that impressed. The effects that they used on him and the CGI, it looked fake to me. And he would always yell, and when he would get mad, yeah, see, he was like an undead creature, but every time he would do that, it was like, oh God, shut him up. Move on with it. Please, somebody kill this guy. He was unkillable, but still, I could get into that. I felt like that they pushed a little bit too much with his character. The pacing was really slow at times. I felt like this movie really didn't know what it was doing. Some of the scenes and some of the action and stuff was just so misplaced. It took me out of the film through most of it. River's direction, I don't want to criticize the man too much, but I just felt like he wasn't really invested that much. It could have been better. The effects in it was cheesy. I couldn't get too much invested in the CGI. They tried too much. There was even a caterpillar looking like city troping around. Every time that showed up, I kind of was giggling a little bit. But I couldn't really get into the effects in this movie. It was cheesy. It looked dumb at some parts. I get that the filmmakers was probably trying, but I felt like they were trying too hard. And also, I felt like the score by Junkie XL was a little far-fetched and out there. He's credited for doing Deadpool, Mad Max Fury Road, and Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice, who also contributed to the Wonder Woman movie theme. I just felt like from what this movie was trying to tell, which was basically a post-apocalyptic war movie, I just felt like his score wasn't right for it, for what this movie was trying to tell. Like I said, I wasn't invested into this movie that much. It felt bland. It wasn't that good, folks. My final thoughts for this movie, despite all the negatives I said, it wasn't terrible. It wasn't crap. But it wasn't good either. It wasn't something that you'd go see and then tell your friends about the next day. Oh, this was such an amazing movie. Oh. No, nothing like that. Mortal Engines gets a C-. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video. I really do appreciate it. Like, subscribe, get reputized. Make sure to subscribe to the Reactor Reactions Galore, which is in the link down in the description below. And make sure to like the Repster and the Reactor on Facebook, which is also down below in the description. What did you guys think of Mortal Engines? Did you hate it? Did you love it? Leave me a comment down below and let me know what you think. Stay tuned for more reviews coming soon. Peace to Rep Out.